As usual, welcome all. Thank you for coming back to F'd Up True Crime and giving us a chance. Now, make sure you hit that subscribe button so that you and the little dingy button so that you never miss any content from F'd Up True Crime. Also, make sure you head on over to our social media pages on Insta, Twitter, Tumblr, and Facebook. Facebook is where I spend the majority of my time if I am on social media. Everything does get pasted into the other social medias, but Facebook just seems to be a little bit more interactive than the other sites are. But we will also be setting up a merch store and sofa mugs, shirts, all those kinds of things, all the cool things. And I really want to put up some toe tag bookmarks as well. All of that will be put up on our pages, so watch out for that. We will also make sure that during this period of time where everything is very unsure, the products will be coming straight from the factory to you. There will be no middleman because we do not want to handle these packages more than we need to. We need to stay safe, everybody. We need to finish fighting this COVID together. Apart, but together. And so I'm going to try and do more of these. If anybody wants to waste some time, pop on over to YouTube. I'll make sure that all of the links are always up on our pages. So, let's get to today's case. Now, trigger warning. This is about a child and a few other children that have picked up a gun and it ended fatally. So if you don't feel you can handle that, please, please, please turn off right now. I would not want you to watch something that you don't think you can handle. It's your mental health is far more important to me. All right. So today's case absolutely pisses me off. Oh, another warning. There will be a lot of language in this one because I am sick to death of America's gun laws and I am sick to death of those people that have their right to carry not safeguarding their children from these weapons. They're not taking the responsibility that needs to be taken when owning a gun. It's not right. It's not right. It is happening far too often. And I will give you the statistics before we finish today so that you have a sense of how desperate things are. All right. So a couple of weeks back, 13-year-old boy from Pennsylvania, who is now going to be tried as an adult after he fatally shot his 9-year-old brother in the head, killing him in a game of cops and robbers. Brayden Leroy Wright of Waynesboro was denied bail after being charged with first degree criminal homicide and second degree aggravated assault, a 13-year-old. Brayden and his brother were said to have been playing together at around 6 a.m. The teenager told officers that he went to fetch one of the two loaded 9mm handguns that his dad keeps in the living room couch to use for the game. A real 9mm. I wouldn't even know where to get one. In Australia, it is not an easy feat, let alone for someone to have a child that knows where dad keeps his loaded handguns. Brayden said, the 13-year-old, that he became angry when his brother was not complying with his commands in the game, guessing that wasn't his actual wording. Probably just said that he wasn't doing what I wanted. Because there is only one 7-year-old on this planet that talks like that, and that's my son. Bit too smart for his own good, for my own good. So he told police how he then went and put the gun to the back of his brother's head as he lay watching YouTube videos. So they weren't even playing by now. This kid is sitting there watching YouTube, and his brother still decided to go and put this gun against his head. He admitted to being angry with the victim for not listening to him. The bullet passed straight through the 9-year-old's skull. Mark Snyder, the boy's father, explained that the presence of the unsecured guns was for home protection. You heard it. Home protection. Yet, couldn't protect his own children. Give me a break. I can't do this anymore. I can't turn on the laptop. I can't turn anything on without seeing a shooting that's come out of the States. Something needs to be done. After shooting his brother, Brayden put the gun back in the couch and called 911 to report a fall, according to the affidavit. So this kid wasn't even going to fess up. He was going to call and say that his brother fell. And I mean, this is the mentality of a 13-year-old. He's hoping that they would take his word for it and not see it. So at 13, when you think that you can cover up a murder with a fall, you are not competent enough to be anywhere near a gun. And it sounds like the father isn't competent either. By the time paramedics arrived at the home, the boy was bleeding severely and was in cardiac arrest. He later died at Waynesboro Hospital as a result of the injuries. Now, this is where things are going to get a bit tricky. A GoFundMe account has been set up to help the family with their legal fees and funeral expenses, along with counseling for the other children in the family, including the boy's three sisters. So the aunt who put up the GoFundMe. Now I'm going to try and not sound pissed off. I'm going to try and sound like mutual, but I don't think it's going to happen. I'll try. I promise I will try, but I am mad. And I'm always mad when I hear about these cases. It boils my blood. The aunt wrote on the GoFundMe, "Please, no rude comments. My family is going through enough. If you do not agree with what the money is used for, then don't donate. He is still just a child. So please, before you send horrible, nasty messages to me, just try to understand that they were both sons, nephews, cousins, grandsons, and friends. And we love them both. I stated when I started this that it was for both of them. And if that's wrong, then simply don't donate. Adding hurt on top of hurt is not helping." In an update on the GoFundMe page, it further stated, "We would like to thank everyone for your support and generosity. His services will be held this coming Wednesday, and he will be buried next to his pappy at Cedar Lawn Cemetery. Thank you for everyone that has helped to make his service and burial possible and special in this difficult time." Now, I am not the sort of person that would reach out to throw bad comments at someone. I would not deliberately go on to upset this family. But this is a discussion that does need to happen. Now, the family said, "Please, no rude comments," and that's cool, no problem. But in return, I'm going to use what the Americans love to use, which is freedom of speech. Now, why? Why are these people asking for help for this kid's trial. I totally understand services. I understand that there are funerals that need to be paid for, and I know, believe me, I know how expensive they are. Very expensive, and I understand that. It maddens me that this is what things have come to. It maddens me that people are having to reach out for help because another child got a hold of a loaded gun. Every child deserves to be buried. Every child, you know what? Children shouldn't be dying. Children shouldn't be dying from cancer. They shouldn't be dying from accidents. They especially shouldn't be dying because of guns. I feel for this family. I honestly feel for this family. But at the same time, I am livid, as you can tell. One family member said, "Yesterday forever changed all of our lives. We not only lost a 9-year-old precious little boy, but we could potentially lose his 13-year-old brother." And it's sad. It's so sad. It really is. I couldn't understand having one child murdered while the other taken away. But I would never let myself get into these sorts of circumstances. I would never, not even living in the States, would ever own a gun. Guns kill people. It's not people kill people. Guns kill people. Because kids don't just always, yes, in this case it's different, but a lot of kids don't think that these guns are loaded. They don't think that there is a risk. Now, this thought process has to change if the Americans aren't going to curb their gun laws. The boys' guardians are not facing any charges as of Sunday. But when will that end? When? Children were killed more than once a week last year under similar circumstances, a loaded gun and an adult's attention lapse. In 2018, at least 73 juveniles under the age of 12 were killed in the USA. And people are still trying to tell me that guns don't kill. 152 deaths from 2014 to 2016, and half, less than half, ended in criminal charges against the people that own these guns. Half. Usually the police come out and say that the adults should have watched the children better. They should have kept the guns in a better, closely secured place. But it seems that no one is getting that message because the deaths aren't going down. They're either staying the same or they're rising. A toddler by the name of Montreal Dunn found a gun and shot himself in the head in Louisville. The 2-year-old was rushed to the hospital in a police cruiser, but he died. Two. 2 weeks later, a Maryland 2-year-old child found a handgun and fatally shot himself. Tyree Flint had discovered the gun in a bedroom while others slept in the home. Things need to change. Our kids are dying for reasons that don't need to exist. If we do in America what we did in Australia, it'd be next to none. Next to no deaths of children with handguns. Here in Australia, our last mass shooting took place in 1996. We are in 2020. On April 28th to 29th, Martin Bryant shot and killed 35 people and injured 24. But the laws immediately changed. The second our government saw that it was so easy to get a hold of handguns, they changed. And we haven't had a mass shooting since. I can honestly say that I can walk down my street. I can walk down the street in the city and know I will not get shot. I can't say that when I'm in the States. The amount of guns I saw when I attended a signing in New Orleans scared the life out of me. I was petrified to go anywhere. I never went anywhere alone. I made sure that I changed hotels to one where there were security officers. I could not believe the amount of guns I saw. In Australia, I can walk around and not see guns under people's shirts. You don't see concealed carry here because it is too damn easy for you to reach back and get that gun in any situation. Jim Jeffries. Now, a lot of people probably think he is sexist and misogynist and all the rest of it. And he is, but I've got a sick and twisted sense of humor. What I find funny isn't what I believe. I just like to sit back and have a laugh without deeply thinking about something. But Jim Jeffries put it in the perfect way.
I don't like guns, right? I'm going to say some things that are just facts, right? In Australia, we had guns, right? Right up until 1996. And in 1996, Australia had the biggest massacre on earth. Still hasn't been beaten. And... now, after that, they banned the guns. Now, in the 10 years before Port Arthur, there was 10 massacres. Since the gun ban in 1996, there hasn't been a single massacre since. I don't know how or why this happened. Maybe it was a coincidence, right? Now, please understand that I understand that Australia and America are two vastly different cultures with different people, right? I get it. In Australia, we had the biggest massacre on earth. The Australian government went, that's it, no more guns. And we all went, yeah, right then, that seems fair enough, really. Now, in America, you had the Sandy Hook massacre where little tiny children died, and your government went, maybe we'll get rid of the big guns? And 50% of you went, fuck you, don't take my guns!
Please, America. Please, America, I implore you to wake up to these gun laws. Save some children's lives. It is far too easy to get a gun over there. Far too easy. And even illegally. The guns over there are so cheap. Yet over here, we would have to pay thousands upon thousands for an illegal gun. It just costs too much. People cannot be bothered in Australia to get them illegally. Yet over there, you can walk into Walmart and buy a gun. Walmart, where you do your groceries, where you do shopping. Now that's creepy. That's scary. I couldn't imagine walking into my Kmart here and having a gun section up the back. They are too readily available. The saddest part, there are so many shootings overseas that they can't even make the daily news. Just think about it. If you own one and you're sitting here watching this, think about the kids. Think about the future. I know it's pretty trippy and, you know, hippie of me to say, but think about peace. There's never going to be peace, I know that. But maybe if we all think about it, maybe if we all change one or two little things about ourselves, about things we do, about anger management and the psychology of anger, maybe we can save someone. I have never been more serious about something in my life. I am rarely serious. I have been in these YouTube clips and podcasts, but in real life, my goodness, I turn everything into a joke. But I can't joke about this. I can't joke about gun laws. I can't joke about children being killed. If no one's got guns, they don't have guns to pull on you, which means you don't have a gun to pull on them. What happened to the good old fist fight? The gentlemanly way, as they would say. I know I would much rather hear that someone, you know, got a black eye than got shot in the head. Wouldn't you? I know there's probably going to be a lot of hate on this, and I understand that. I understand that we live in different countries, and I understand that we have different ways, but these gun laws really work here. They really work here. Like I said, 1996 was our last mass shooting. And yet in America, it was probably 2 days ago. There are so many shootings. I couldn't believe how many shootings go on that we don't hear about. It's sad and deeply concerning. But that's everything I have for today, because I am now exhausted. Utterly exhausted. After researching this case, I was just so angry, and so I had a migraine start to come on, but thank goodness for the doctor. Got rid of that. But let's all look, right now is the most together we're all going to be. We are all in a pandemic together. We all need to look after each other. So how about we focus on that rather than focus on getting the guns to protect our homes? I hope someone got some good out of this. I don't know if anybody will get any good out of this, but I hope someone did, because it's something that I am very, very passionate about. Yet I live in Australia, so there really isn't all that much I can do from here. No one's going to listen to the stupid idiot Aussie from down under. It needs to come within. You need a president that's going to take charge. You need a president that isn't just there for his own business model. You need someone that really cares. I don't know who that person is. It's definitely not Biden. Let me tell you. Good old creepy Uncle Joe. It's not him. And it's definitely not Kanye West. I don't know who could do this, because our Prime Minister is a wanker. Like, we have a real dickhead in charge down here. But he abides by our gun laws. He might be a dickhead in some ways, but at least he's kept that the same. Please, everybody, stay safe. Please wear your masks. Please don't leave your home unless you have to. Stay safe and check in with us. Just let us know you're okay. Thanks, guys. Bye.
The parents of a 13-year-old charged with killing his 9-year-old brother in Franklin County are also facing charges. Both Mark and Stacy Wright Snyder are accused of endangering the welfare of children. The criminal complaint alleges that they kept two unsecure loaded handguns around five kids between 7 and 13 years old, while the children were unsupervised. Snyder's bail is set at $100,000. Wright Snyder's bail is set at $75,000. The 13-year-old is homicide.
Hey guys, this is a quick update. The parents of a 13-year-old boy accused of fatally shooting his little brother knew the teen would handle guns and even point them at his siblings. This is what their other children told the deputies. These details were revealed in the affidavits of probable cause supporting the charges filed against the parents, Mark Wayne Snyder and Stacy Renee Wright Snyder. The couple have each been charged with two felony counts of child endangerment. They have been in Franklin County Jail the last couple of days. And Snyder is being held on $100,000 bail, and the mother is being held on $75,000 bail. In interviews with police, the three minor siblings of the victim and suspect said that he would handle handguns in the home and would point the guns at them. The children said their parents knew about this. One of the children said it had just happened the night leading up to the incident. Police determined that Snyder and Wright Snyder were both at home at the time. Police stated in the affidavit that due to the living conditions in the family's home, they've condemned the house. Oh my God, does that mean it's like a hoarder home? Oh, holy crap, I really need to read this stuff like 20 times before I come to you guys with it. Holy shit. The living conditions were that bad that it was condemned. No wonder they didn't give a shit about two handguns being loaded in the house. He probably thought that no one could find them. Oof. The son is still being charged as an adult, even though he's 13 years old. I'm not even sure what to think of it. I'm not sure if he should be tried as an adult. I don't know if he should be tried as a minor, but that is not up to me. That is not my decision to make. The family is trying to raise funds to have the appeals made because they are saying it's between $11,000 and $14,000 for a lawyer to be able to even just make a case saying that he should be charged as a minor. Now, if and when there are updates on this case, just like I've done right now, I will come back and update you all because this, you know how pissed off I was about the guns. So it's no big surprise to you guys. But I am so glad these parents have been arrested. I'm so glad. Because if they didn't have the guns, if they stored the guns properly even, this wouldn't have happened. And for his own protection, it's sheer, like the father, okay. The father said he had the guns around the house loaded for protection. Now, protection from who? Himself? But, his kid against his other kids? Come on. But, the very fact that he had them stored in the couch just tells me how fucking lazy he is as a human being. He's gotta be. He's gotta be batshit lazy. Because he couldn't. And it's not a matter of protection for the family. Not in this case. In this case it was, I'm too lazy. And I'll just use that as an excuse. So, the whole thing just blew me away. I'm sorry. I just got the Google alerts and I was like, holy shit. But yeah, so any more updates, I will make sure that I will type in new update or whatever, and I'll make sure I put it on all the social media pages so you know to go back to the video, but to the last like 5 minutes. Yeah, so there's your update for that one. I didn't think we'd get an update that fast, but I guess, so I went out of my way to bitch at the police department to say that them not being charged is a load of bullshit. And of course I'm not gonna sit here and think, hey, yay, it was me, and it wasn't. But I'm glad I voiced it. I'm glad that, because I feel like I haven't done anything, you know? The war on guns. It's got to come to an end, guys. It's really got to come to an end. Get rid of the damn things. Get rid of war. Get rid of it all. But that- That's not going to happen, unfortunately. But yeah, thanks for sticking around, and I will be back in the next day or so. Thanks, guys.